The focus of our research is being able to better characterize the microscopic properties of brain tissue. We're daring to ask, how far can we push MRI to characterize tissue microscopic properties so that it can help patients? We're trying to create better methods that characterize tissue properties more specifically. These properties might include the shape of the cells or whether there's inflammation. And sometimes the cell shape can become abnormal in disease, and we're trying to characterize that. The second branch of our research is to actually apply these new methods to learn more about disease and to see whether they can actually improve our diagnosis of disease. I'd say there's multiple levels of goals for our research. At the highest level, we want to improve the quality of life of patients. At the specific level, we're trying to better characterize the specific tissue properties of the disease and use that to actually improve patient care. One of the problems is that these new methods that we're developing, they need to be validated. So we can develop sophisticated models that predict the cell properties, but we have to know that it's true. So the methods we deal with require a long time to acquire all the data you need to characterize tissue microstructure. So we're building hardware that allows us to get this data in less time and also to achieve higher resolution. One of the most unique things is our ability to translate our research across different domains. So here at our center, we have a small animal MRI where we can do animal models and actually validate the microstructure that we're measuring is correct. We can take those imaging methods and do the exact same methods on our human scanners. And then we can take what we learned from the animals and directly apply it to human patients. My hope for the future is that a patient can come in, get an MRI scan that accurately characterizes what is happening at a cellular level. And from there, we know exactly what subtype of disease they have and exactly what type of treatment they need to receive.